Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. In the 20th century, institutionalized science embraced the concept of a universe dominated by invisible forces and entities. We are told that no less than 96% of the known universe is composed of invisible dark matter and dark energy. We are also told that at the core of every large galaxy is a supermassive black hole, a region which is said to have such an intense gravitational field that nothing can escape, not even light. The concept of the black hole is thought to account for the stupendous energies and mass at galactic cores. In our own celestial neighborhood, we are told that at the outer reaches of the solar system is a never-seen spherical cloud of icy bodies known as the Oort cloud, from which most long-period comets supposedly originated. Of course, these concepts are the products of a cosmology in which gravity is the predominant force. Today, Thunderbolt's colleague Bishop Nicholas Sykes discusses the tenability of both black holes and the Oort cloud in the light of science discovery, and he explores some of the theoretical alternatives in an electric universe.
In the standard paradigm, a black hole is considered to be an entity of such huge mass that even light cannot escape from its gravitational attraction. That is why it is considered to be absolutely black. Moreover, once any body possessing mass has fallen into it beyond its event horizon, it will never be able to escape or be detected. Until recently, a black hole was considered to swallow anything and everything that approached it. But in more recent times, Stephen Hawking announced that information could escape from it, albeit in garbled form. However, it has now become standard to claim that a black hole may be the source of powerful synchrotron radiation. It is also claimed that supermassive black holes occupy the heart of galaxies, and indeed that one resides at the heart of our own Milky Way galaxy. This is because the observed high speed of revolution of certain massive entities around the supposed position of a black hole at the heart of the galaxy. One can conceive of a black hole, therefore, as functioning in a similar manner to dark matter, the presence of which is considered to be necessary in a gravitational universe to hold together a galaxy or a group of galaxies, for without it, the angular velocity of the outermost portions would cause them to become detached from the whole. However, black holes and dark matter originated as two separate concepts. Black holes are not themselves depicted as consisting of dark matter. Nevertheless, the need for them both arises in standard cosmology from the same problem. That is, there is not nearly enough verifiable matter to provide the gravitational force understood to be necessary from the observation of galactic velocities to provide the cohesion that is also observed. Both black holes and dark matter, however, suffer from equally baffling conceptual difficulties, which should cause anyone of a scientific or rational frame of mind to question their very existence. Each concept's conceptual difficulty results in its being fundamentally unverifiable with the tools of science. A black hole cannot be seen because no light can leave one. Dark matter is defined in a manner that conceives it to possess gravitational force, but not to manifest its existence by the senses in the way ordinary matter does. If we were not beholden to the idea that gravity ruled the universe, we might well be tempted to regard them both as examples of mathematical fudge. In the electric universe paradigm, we are indeed not beholden to the understanding that the cosmos is held together principally by gravity. In an electric universe, the presence of the electric force, which can reasonably be regarded as 10 to the power 39, i.e. 1,000 million, 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 million times as strong as the gravitational force, is what changes everything. It is the electric force that holds in the bodies that revolve at otherwise unaccountable rates. And indeed, that accounts for the synchrotron radiation detected by astronomers. Because of this electric force, operating in a somewhat similar way to Faraday's homopolar motor, the fudge of neither dark matter nor black holes is necessary to account for the cosmic cohesion that we see and both concepts can be consigned to the dustbin of human history. Comets and the Oort cloud. The Oort cloud is named for the astronomer Jan Hendrik Oort, who sought to explain that comets would have had to be stored for billions of years in a cold, dark, and wet cloud around the outermost reaches of the solar system before some eventually escaped and made their way into its more central regions nearer the sun. Oort and a predecessor, Ernst Oppich, reasoned that the currently observed paths of comets cannot be where they were originally formed, at the time the solar system was supposedly formed, because in that case, by now, they would all have either collided with the sun or been ejected from the solar system by planetary perturbations. The explanation is considered appropriate enough for a scenario of comets as dirty snowballs coming into the inner solar system as cold, wet, and dusty. The heat of the sun, it is supposed, will boil off the moisture and any other volatile material until the comet develops an insulating crust and will force the dusty material of the comet to dissipate as a tail. Unfortunately for this explanation, the actual behavior or observed composition of comets has not conformed at all well with it. Direct analysis of comets has never produced evidence of anything cold and slushy about them or within them. The electric universe paradigm, however, provides a scenario of comets being the remnants of planetary interactions of a mainly electrical nature. Cometary surfaces, which are hard like their interiors, typically show evidence of deep electrical scarring or machining. When they interact with the sun or even with artificial projectiles, as in the Temple 1 experiment, evidence is provided of the rapid neutralization of differing electrical potentials when the interacting bodies become close. The experimenters were amazed in the Temple 1 deep impact interaction experiment that a flash of light was seen before the projectile hit the comet's surface, and that a far greater flash than expected was seen on impact. However, these unexpected observations conformed with what the electric universe researcher Wal Thornhill had predicted. The electrical energy input to the impact explosion had, of course, been omitted by the standard theorists, as well as the consideration of any possibility of an advanced flash. Like other imaginary concepts born of the inadequate assumptions of the gravitational universe paradigm, which should now be ripe for wholesale overthrow, the supposed Oort cloud is a fiction. The existence of comets on their present trajectories with the use of current tools of observation and analysis reveals their genesis to be not in the distant past, but rather in a solar system that has been powerfully interactive in relatively recent times. Such a conclusion, unfeasible in the old paradigm, is made possible by an electric universe paradigm, for which the phenomenon of comets provides, along with a host of other observations and phenomena, massive additional confirmation.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.